was the town that made America famous. The church is full and the kids all gone to hell. Six traffic lights and seven cops, and all the streets kept clean. The supermarket and the drugstore and the bars all doing well. Now they were the folks that made America famous. The local fire department stocked with short-haired volunteers. And on Saturday night, while America boozes, the fire department showed dirty movies. The lawyer and the grocer seeing their dreams come to life on the movie screens, while the plumber hopes that he won't be seen as he tries to hide his fears and he wipes away his tears. But something's burning somewhere. Does anybody care? Now we were the kids that made America famous. The kind of kids that long since drove our parents to despair. We were lazy long hairs dropping out, lost, confused, and cropping out, convinced our futures were in doubt and trying not to care. And we lived in the house that made America famous. It was a rundown slum, the shame of all the decent folks in town. Yes, we hippies and some welfare cases, crowded families of cold black faces, cramped inside some cracked old boards, the best that we all could afford, but still too fine for the rich landlord to ever tear it down. So we could hear the sound of something burning somewhere. Is anybody there? We all lived the life that made America famous. Our cops would make a point to shadow us around our town. And we loved children, put a swastika on the Braidwood firehouse door. America the beautiful, it makes a body proud. And then came the night that made America famous. Was it carelessness or someone's sick idea of a joke? In the tinderbox trap that we hippies lived in, someone struck a spark. At first I thought that I was dreaming, then I saw the first flames gleaming and heard the sound of children screaming coming through the smoke. And something's burning somewhere. Does anybody care? It was the fire that made America famous. The sirens wailed and the firemen stumbled sleepy from their homes. And when the plumber yelled, "Come on, let's go," they saw what was burning and said, "Take it slow, let them sweat a little, they'll never know. And besides, we just cleaned the chrome," said the plumber, "then I'm going along." Well, he rolled on up in the fire truck and raised the ladder to the ledge, where me and my girl and a couple of kids were clinging like bats to the edge. We staggered to salvation and collapsed on the street. And I never thought that a fat man's face would ever look so sweet. I shook his hand in the scene that made America famous. And his smile from the heart that made America great. We spent the rest of that night in the home of this man that we'd never known before. It's funny when you get that close, it's kinda hard to hate. I went to sleep with the hope that made America famous. I had the kind of a dream that maybe they're still trying to teach in school, of the America that made America famous, and of the people who just might understand that how together, yes, we can create a country better than the one we have made of this land. We have the choice to make each man who dares to dream, reaching out his hand, a prophet or just a crazy goddamn dreamer of a fool. Yes, a goddamn fool. And something's burning somewhere. Does anybody care? Is anybody